We got another great package from my friends at Eurocharge today, and when you see what they are, you'll know what the video is about. There we go. These are the 550cc 52 pound hour Bosch injectors. So this video is going to be about installing them. Alternatively, you can use it to see what steps are required to rebuild your current injectors. Sometimes the O-ring seals on the top and bottom of the injector start to crack over time and you might lose a little fuel pressure, or sometimes if you look on the intake manifold area you can see a little bit of like residue as some of the fuel escapes past the O-rings and very slowly leaks out. You might smell a little bit of fuel, so that's what can happen. And every couple of years it's always good to refresh the injector O-rings top and bottom. If yours have replaceable filters, you can do that, and also the pintle caps on the injectors. So there's injector rebuild kits you can get, but basically you got to take out the inlet manifold, the air filter, the fuel rails, the throttle body, all that stuff to get down into the area where the injectors are. So that's what this video is going to be about, replacing or refreshing your injectors. Okay, you see the six holes in the fuel injectors? These are the EV14 Bosch 550cc 52 pound high performance injectors. So I'm going to be installing these and having the custom tune done, but you actually need an adapter. So these are the adapters here. And so now it'll plug into the stock Mercedes wiring harness. So the first step in removing the fuel injectors, just getting off your air intake system, depending on what kind you have. Then you're going to take a T30 Torx bit and remove all these bolts. As you can see, I've already done this one. Down here is a rubber fitting. You need to go ahead and loosen that up. This is a 7mm hose clamp. Then you remove the gasket. Once you've done that, the very first, most important thing is to get some tape and cover up your intake ports. These go directly into the cylinder of the engine, so it's very important. Duct tape works really well, but I guess I'm out of duct tape, so this blue tape works all right. Where the surge tanks connect to, take a microfiber or a rag and put it right there. Now repeat for the other side, and then we're going to go ahead and depressurize the fuel rail, unbolt it, loosen up the throttle body, get that out of the way, then we can work on removing the injectors. Okay, at this point, what I've done is gone ahead and removed the bolts that hold down the fuel rails themselves. I unscrewed the throttle body and removed these air hoses here. So now you can actually just lift the fuel injectors right up and out. And everything is still attached. Get this out of the way. So now, next thing to do is unclip them. And the easiest way I found is you pliers. Okay, so now that the rails are out like this, we can go ahead and actually remove the injectors. So the way you do that, by prying back these clips one at a time. That. What they do is index the fuel injectors in the right position. Always keep the dust covers on till right when you're going to install them.
All set.